Hello, class. My name is George Streeter, and I'll be your professor of ethics this semester. In this short video, I'm going to speak a little bit about the idea of an ethics class and what we're going to be focusing on together. The big question that we'll start with is, how should one live? That's the big ethical question. How should I go about living my life? What does it mean to commit myself to a way of life? That begins a reflection, a self-reflection, on the kinds of things I value. Why do I make the choices that I make? What kinds of values do I embrace in my life? What are the ideals that I set for myself? And the process of reflection that we'll do together in this class brings me to a place where I can not only understand that better for myself, but be in a position to explain to other people who might disagree with me why I value the things that I do, and why I'm committed to the kinds of projects that I commit myself to, and why I set those ideals for myself in the way that I do. So, for example, I believe in solidarity, in building community through solidarity. What does it mean to commit yourself to that? And to value that, to set that as an ideal? And how would you go about explaining that to someone else if they didn't understand why community mattered or why building solidarity mattered? Taking an ethics class will help you reflect on those kinds of questions, help you come to a better understanding of who you are and why you've chosen to live the life that you're living, and also come to a better understanding of other people and their perspectives, which often differ from your own. It also puts you in a position to think about conflicts in value. Anytime you make a commitment to something, let's say you're committed to promoting more equality or removing barriers to inequality in the workplace or in some sector of society, this is something I believe in. So what does it really mean to commit yourself to that, to the ideal of equality? Well, part of it means facing conflicts between equality and other things that you value and figuring out how to resolve those conflicts for yourself. So maybe a choice between going on another vacation this spring break and using that time to go and volunteer at a soup kitchen. Those are the kinds of choices that a person can make. If I'm really committed to social equality, how do I go about justifying or explaining to myself and others why I make the choices that I make? That's one way to think about our topic this semester and the question of how one should live. And I'm trying to put it in the context of self-reflection. This is a course in which you'll have an opportunity to reflect on yourself and also think about the world that you live in. Those go together. It's a complicated world. There's a lot going on out there that's hard to understand. The news cycle doesn't always help us understand that. So one of the things that we can do in this class is think about the basic concepts that structure our social world together and try to come to a better understanding of them and the principles behind the decisions that we make and the basic structures of society that we preserve or sometimes fight to reform. We'll do a lot of reading together and talk about these kinds of questions that you'll have a chance to write. But the goal throughout is to come to a better understanding of what it means for you to commit yourself to a way of life, to protect certain basic values, to promote certain basic ideals that you care about, and what it means for you to come to an understanding of other people when you try to go about defending yourself or explaining yourself, and you find that other people might disagree with you. So I hope you'll see by the end of the semester, ethics is really about learning how to talk to each other, learning how to share values with each other, even when we disagree, and come to agreements, even when it seems like all we face is conflict. So, I mean, that's one of the things about the world we live in right now. It seems full of divisions and conflict. But oftentimes those divisions and conflicts on the surface, right, conceal a deeper agreement about basic values and basic commitments to a way of life. So we'll have a chance to talk about that in the context of some of the things that we're reading, but also I want to hear from you throughout the semester, your own perspective on the choices that you make in living your life and the values that you're trying to preserve and the ideals that you're trying to promote and where you come up against conflicts and where you come up against disagreements with other people and how you go about resolving those, how you go about making difficult decisions and resolving difficult conflicts in your life. I hope that sounds interesting to you, and I look forward to raising those questions and discussing them in the context of what we're reading and looking at what you have to say in your writing about those kinds of questions. And again, it's a class in which you will have a chance to reflect on the life that you're living and how you live with others and how you resolve conflicts with others in your life. That's all for now. Hope that helps you frame and think about the larger context, the bigger picture of the class. A lot will obviously have to come out in the details. And so that will wait until we actually have class and you begin working through some of the assignments. Okay, that's all.